Hello and welcome back. I am Mike the Aardvark, and this is part 3 of my walkthrough for the Temple of Amun-Ra by AgentXP. So let's press on. If you remember from last time, we said that we had to find 4 stones to proceed to the next part of the level, and in this area we can open up areas to 2 more places to get the remaining 2 stones. We had 2 stones in the last level, so let's start pushing blocks about. Two of these blocks have dogs behind them. This one has a small med pack. I like to be tidy, so let's put it back into its cubby hole. I think this one has a door to one of the areas. As you can see, it's closed by a gate, but we'll soon have that open. Right, I believe this one has a dog behind it. And again, tidy up. I think this is the way to the other area. Well, that's 3 areas. One of them is obviously not an area. This one reveals a lever. Which will open one of those 2 gates. Oh, there's a couple of three scorpions. And this requires one of the stars. Opens the gate. still, a few more blocks required for tidying up. Dog behind this one? Or is it behind the other one? No, this small mid pack. This is the one that has a dog behind it. Oh, I've boxed myself in. Not sure what happened there. Oh, I think I managed to glitch between the blocks. Well, let's tidy this one away again. This one can go into the corner. Right then. Final star opens the way to this area. I think we should do this one first. Door shuts behind us. We have to complete this before we are allowed out again. First thing is to go down to the lower level. And there are crocodiles in this area. Two to start with, I think, or is it only the one? Two to start with. Now, this is an underwater lever, so we have to flood this area somehow. Here is a waterfall pouring down a drain. If we can move a block over the drain, we'll start flooding the area. So that's what this one is for. However, before we actually do that, we need to find a lever down here and pull it, which opens the way to a secret up above, because once this area is flooded, we won't get another chance. So, pull this one out a couple of times so we can get behind it. Doesn't show you what it does, but it opens a gate that's protecting the secrets. And it generates another crocodile. Okay. Push the block over the drain. Nice little flyby. Pull the lever, which opens that gate. So start making our way out. Now then, sometimes it doesn't work if she's right in the corner, and this needs to be a control and forward, otherwise she won't jump quite high enough. Now if we look at these two gold pillars, the far one has the stone that we are looking for, so obviously you would think jump to this one, jump to that one. However, let's see what happens if you do. Oh no, Lara's turned to gold. Clunk. So that's no good. I'll have to find another way to get there. Unfortunately, there are cracks all the way around this room at various levels, and then we can shimmy over to the various platforms. So we need to just jump down onto that, making sure that we don't overshoot. I think I'll take a safety save. I did say don't overshoot. Whoa, very nearly did. Now, before we pick this up, when we pick it up, on the other pillar there's going to be a doppelganger Lara, and a harpy will be spawned. Don't shoot the Lara image or it will take health off you, and when the harpy attacks the other Lara, it again will take health off you. So I want to select the Desert Eagle, which is a nice powerful gun, and also I found that by staying up on here it was very difficult not to target Lara, so I'm going to pick the stone up and hop backwards. Oh no! Right, that wasn't too bad. Got rid of the harpy. Now we need to make our way up again. So, jump down onto here. Hop! And start all over again. only this time, instead of jumping down to grab the stone, we'll keep on going up and up and up and up. When we land on the next platform, another harpy will be spawned. So take care of him. More ledge climbing shimmying. And around and around and around we go. This was the gate that was opened by the underwater lever. So pull up in and start crawling around. If you look through this gate, that's the secret area. And now we need to crawl past a burner. We jolly well go. Double back here. There's some shotgun shells. No, it's a large medipack. Anyway, now that we open the gate to the secret area, before we flooded the room below, we can pick up some more goodies. A small med pack, and then two vars to shoot. Don't waste your ammo, use your pistols. There's an eagle. Ammo. Desert Eagle ammo again. And yet more Desert Eagle ammo. This will come in useful for the end sequence. Where we have some pretty nasty enemies. Pull this lever and that opens a flap so that we can go up even higher. We need to time past the burner once more. The off times are pretty generous on these. Now above us is the flap that opened, which enables us to jump up into here. Nothing behind us. Again, nothing behind us. We want to hop back and grab so we can shimmy at the next level up. And and around we go. We're very nearly completed with this room. Over there is the switch that will open the exit door, or the entrance door, depending which way you look at it. And let us get back out again. There we go. Pop back over here. One last pickup. Shotgun shells. So now we have three of the four stones. The Ra from the Temple of the Torturer, Nebu we just picked up, and Sorbeck was the one in the water room. All we have to do now is drop into the water and make our way out. We've also got the two canopic jars, but they don't actually do anything in this game. Splash. Oh, come on. Some visible barrier there. Pop up a couple of times. Pop over to the platform and make our way out. So, one stone left to collect, and it is through here. This room also has crocodiles. So ready the shotgun. Swim down, pull up as quickly as you can because the crocodiles are floating about the water. Two of them, I believe. Where are they hiding? They tend to swim round the outside. Ah, there we go. Probably coming out this side now. No, he's doubled back. Well, let's save in case we run off into the water. Get our ass bitten. Where are they hiding? Oh, there's one. There's one down. I think there's one nestling over here. That's both of them, I believe. There's another one that comes later. But there are a number of pickups in the water. Starting with a med pack. don't keep searching and forget to surface for air every now and again. I'm sure we're still not done. Oh yes, no. Here we go. Lovely desert eagle clips. And health packs. I think that's about it for pickups in the water. Now, at the far right there's a lever which raises one of these two platforms. The other one, can't quite see it from here. Let's hop over here then. An underwater lever opens that door, which has a lever to raise the other platform. But before we do that, there's another med pack here. So run down to the other end. Pop up. Pull the lever, that raises one of the two flaps. Down here there's an underwater lever which opens the door I showed you. Also spawns a crocodile. So we want to swim up and pull up sharpish like. Oh dear. Never mind, that'll do. Where is he? Hiding somewhere. There he is. And he's done for. So, what now? We start to go up. From here we can reach this ledge. And if we hop up onto this block, we can make it over to this pillar, and a skeleton appears. So let's just load our grenade launcher. Oh well, didn't quite reach that far. Still. We go. Now we can use this block to get into the little cubbyhole we opened. Pull the lever to raise the other platform. quite sure why she isn't grabbing that there. Let's have a checkpoint save. And here we go then. This will raise the other platform. So now we've got a complete path of pushing the block. Need to get the block at the other end so we can climb on it and jump up to the next level. Do it. Pop up, turn round, and we're up onto this ladder. Climb up. Now there's another block there, which we need to position so that we can pull the lever, which you can see on the wall. However, we need that platform to be raised so we can stand on it to push. And that lever, to do that, is in there. However, as soon as we jump up on here, we're going to wake up the skeleton over there and a couple of dogs. So the easiest thing to do is to jump up, flip back, and take care of the dogs. Get our grenade launcher out for taking care of the skeleton. Whoops! I missed. Top two series. Just climb back up again. He's gone. The next enemies are going to be some more dogs. Now before you pull this, it's a timed lever, so that flat will come up, stay for a bit and then drop down again. So if you haven't pushed the block in time, it won't be good. There we go, spin round. Jump over. Oh dear, messed up. Try again. Is quite generous. Well, we nearly blew it there. Pull the lever, opens the gate by the skeleton. What do I keep doing wrong there? What? You saw me do it three times. Why is this one not working? Perhaps it's just an ordinary stand jump. There we go. Oh, we don't need this just yet. We've got some chop blades to get through. First one is easy. Oh dear, walked into that. We won't worry about the health buff. However, this one, you've got to jump over a fire pit and also dodge the blades. I do that by a swan dive. So if you hold, walk and jump forward down, should do a swan dive. I'm waiting for the fire to go out and the blades then to just start going up again, like now. No, not like now. For some reason I'm getting the timing wrong. That's better. Need to do it once more. No. Perhaps you need to jump when the blades are together. No, you don't need to jump when the blades are together. Part way up, I thought it was. A mess of this. Perhaps it's when the blades start coming down again. Something is going wrong here. Wrong. I'm sure that's what I did for the last lot. Sometimes this just baffles me. Do exactly the same thing, but different results happen. But it is just a matter of timing. Seem to have forgotten what the right time is. This is embarrassing. Save a bit nearer to the fire going out, so we don't have to wait not too long each time. Well, that's wrong. Okay, fully up, see what happens there. No, that's not right either. Team swan dive that time. Perhaps that's what it is, she's not swan diving. As soon as you move this block, which you have to push inwards, three dogs are going to attack. So make sure you've got your shotgun selected. And here we go. You can actually pop up onto the block. Not time for that. One more. There he is. Okay. There are four switches. two of them are in little cubby holes protected by chop blades. One is on the ground level behind a block, and one is in a cubby hole that you just saw over there with no chop blades. What we have to do is to pull them all, and that will explode that vase on the central pillar and give us access to the final key of the level. Actually, pulling the four switches will lower this green block, which then has a lever to do what I just said. So let's get some blocks in position. Pull this one about three times, is it? Yep, I'm not going to go through just yet. Going to move this one under the second chop blade. No, don't jump up, pull. Hop over. Let's push it against the wall and then drag it along one. Another one. There's a third movable. Is this the one? No, of course, it's this one. Or is it this one? It's this one. See, there's the fourth lever. Oh, push, don't jump. Ah, I'd forgotten. The author made some fixes in this version 2 of the level, to avoid a potential bug where if you leave a block on this white tile, it can ruin the level for you. So I think I've got to move all these blocks around by 90 degrees and do it that way, which is a bit of a pain. But we'll see what is what in a short while. So I've effectively pushed the blocks a little bit further than I needed to, and then have to push them back again. Right, that's that one. Now, let's make sure we can get that one through there. Two blocks placed. Nearly got the last one in position. Okay, let's have a checkpoint save. If we look at these four grates surrounding the pot up there, at the moment none of them are spewing fire, but they will in a minute when we turn on all these switches. Now I think the timing for this one is to jump just as it's starting to go up at about 45 degrees on the way up, like that. Pull the switch and obviously just run through when it's open. Next one, please. At least this one doesn't have any blades in front of it. And finally, this has dropped this lock, and this is the lever that will do everything. Unfortunately, when I pull this, there's going to be an explosion and there'll be pulse damage of a random amount depending on exactly how the explosion works, and there will be a dog that will come and nip at my heels, although sometimes he gets blown up. So let's see what we do there. Wasn't too bad actually. However, apart from these two pillars raised, we've got fire all the way around there, which we have to turn off, otherwise we won't be able to pick up the stone without being turned into a crispy Lara. So we have to unpull these switches. I'm not sure if it's just one of them or all of them. We'll do the easy ones first. Well, that seems to have done it. Okay. Since we're on here, we use it to hop up to this one. Okay, it's one of those types of moves. Go to the back. Angle slightly inwards. Jump and miss. So what went wrong there then? That's better. Now pull up in the corner. Wait for the flame to go out. It's periodic. I expect there would have been time to pick it up, however. And hop back down again. So we now have all of the four stones. Sobek, Nebu, Osiris we've just picked up, and Ra. So checkpoint save, run over to the other block, hop up into here, which is going to be a quick way down. All the way into the water. Splash. And swim around and back out again. I think they've hidden it. No, here it is. Always go the wrong way. Here we are. No, not here we are. So that's three corners. See what happened? I should have turned left and went all the way around there. Now we've killed all the enemies so far except for that one skeleton in the very first pit. Now we've got the grenade launcher. We could go back and take him out, but it's really not worth it. I mean, I would do it if it was me, but I won't make you watch while we do that. So we place the four stones. Placing the last stone will open a gate over in that corner. In here, towards the back, there is a lever. which lowers a block in the pool. Not sure if there's any pickups in here. I tend to think not. Pretty sure there weren't any in the water. Oh, yes, there is one. So let's shoot the bass and get some more shotgun ammo. I think that's about it, though. Down where the block lowered, pull the lever. That door opens. Pretty close to the end now. Maybe about 10-15 minutes. Now ready your Desert Eagle, because there are two demigods in here.